if we're going to measure instantaneous speed, another situation that we can work with is, let's say I've got a rock and I'm just going to drop it. Then we can predict how far that rock will drop based on physical equations that people have figured out a long time ago. If you measure it in feet, the distance in feet and the time in seconds, then the distance traveled by the rock after you drop it is 16 times t squared, where t is the number of seconds that have gone by. So let's say I'm going to drop a rock, and I want to know exactly how fast it's traveling 4 seconds after I've dropped it. So maybe I'm on top of a building or dropping it off of a bridge or something. If I drop it and then I wait 4 seconds, I want to know how fast is it traveling at that specific moment in time. So I'm not asking for the average speed of what's the average between the moment I dropped it and 4 seconds later. I'm asking just how fast is it moving. If it was to hit something 4 seconds later, how fast is it moving? Because if I know how fast it's moving, I can know what kind of an impact it's going to make on that thing, whatever it hits. So we'll use the idea that the car uses, where you take really small increments of time to approximate how fast that thing is traveling at a specific moment in time. So what we're going to do is we'll say, all right, after this thing has been traveling 4 seconds, then let's let it travel another 1 second after that 4 seconds. So from 4 seconds to 5 seconds, let's measure how far it travels during that amount of time. And let's divide it by the amount of time that's gone by, which would be 1 second from t equals 4 to t equals 5. So we can do that. We can use the equation 16 t squared, plug in t equals 5 to get how far it travels in 5 seconds, and then plug in t equals 4 to get where it would be after 4 seconds. Take the difference of those two positions, and that's how far it travels from t equals 4 to t equals 5, and then divide by the amount of time. So we'll divide by 1 in that case, and we can get that average speed. And that gives us some kind of approximation of how fast it was traveling after 4 seconds. But we would really like to know more precisely how fast it's traveling. So after we have that value, we'll look at, let's say, the average speed, where we, instead of taking an interval of 1 second from t equals 4 to t equals 5, let's take a smaller interval of half a second. So from t equals 4 to t equals 4.5. And we'll go through the same calculation, but we'll use 4.5 instead of 5. So we'll do distance at 4.5 minus distance at 4 seconds, and we'll divide by the amount of time, which is 1/2, and then we get another average speed. And now let's do it again for, let's say, a tenth of a second. So this time our time interval is even shorter, a tenth of a second. So I'm going to do the distance after 4.1 seconds minus the distance after 4 seconds, and then divide by the amount of time that's gone by, which is 1/10. That gives me another average speed. So of those three average speeds that we calculated using t equals 4 to t equals 5, t equals 4 to t equals 4.5, t equals 4 to t equals 4.1, which of those average speeds gives us the most accurate prediction of how fast the rock is traveling exactly at 4 seconds? It's the one with the smallest amount of time, smallest interval of time. So the last average speed that we calculated gives us the best approximation. We could go ahead and do it a step further. We could let that time interval be 1/100th of a second. We could make that calculation, get that average speed. Now, if we have all four of those average speeds, we can take a look at them. We can line them up and take a look at them and see if they're approaching a specific number. So the first average speed that we calculated, then the next one, then the next one, then the next one, they should be getting closer and closer to a very specific number. And that specific number is the number that we want. So that specific number comes out to be about 128 feet per second. That's what you see the numbers, the average speeds approaching. So we would predict that, or we would, I guess, conclude that we believe the rock is traveling 128 feet per second based on that.